Hi everyone, so today I'm going to try and replace this PMU which have a short on VDD main. I have damaged it in corner when I was cleaning glue to scan the logic board. This logic board was destined to make solutions. So I'm going to replace the PMU to remove the short on VDD main and see how it goes. I am not going to be able to test this logic board. So I hope the readings will be fine. I am going to use the old method with soldering iron on top. So now first step is to clean this black tape with 180 Celsius of temp and a split tweezers, something like this. The soldering iron method on top of the egg was first I found out about it when I was fixing Nokia mobile phones. There was an EME egg, not sure if I say right. It was some filters for the LCD image. We were removing it with soldering iron on top and adding jumpers. Maybe some of you remember doing this. So I'm going to try the method on the PMU because it's made of silicone, semi-X. Most of it are made of silicone. This is first time when I am cracking a PMU and it got short. First time. It never happened before. So nothing is excluded that it can happen in future. I think it's not needed to clean out this thing, black tape, from the PMU. It's enough in the middle, but I will clean it anyway. Also, the new PMU that I have bought, I'm not sure if it is good. But the PMU is new from AliExpress seller. So I will test one. Okay, I have finished cleaning this black tag. Now I am going to try and unsolder the PMU with soldering iron on top. Make sure the soldering iron tip is big enough to cover the egg and give 300 PMU. So I will try with 300 of temp on top and see if it will unsolder. Okay, let's make a big drop of solder. So I have prepared a needle from a syringe and we'll try to pry it out. This flux is not good here. I'm going to clean this flux because the ink must be dry and solder will stick to the surface of the ink. If not help this, I will lift the temp. Of the soldering iron. Fuck. You can see how without flux the solder sticks to the surface of the ink. Fuck, I will clean this shit. My solder have flux and when I add it, it have stick the flux to the ink from the soldering iron tip and I will have to add more, I think. And then I will clean. The tip is not, I need other type of tip, which is not like this. But it must be like a finger. The tip must have a form like a finger or a nail of a dragon. It tells me the temp is not enough. So I have lift the temp to 350. And we'll see how it will go. Most ground on the PMU is in the middle of the ink. Okay, I see something goes on. And the ink is lifting slowly I hope I did not remove it. Oh my gosh, I have destroyed some parts on the logic board, fuck. Because of the sheet of needle. Okay, so Daik have removed it easy. But with some damages. Because this sheet of camera is not aligned with what I see. Here is the PMU. Now I will have to see what I have destroyed here. Here are some pads. There is a fucking code. I will replace the soldering iron tip and see what I can do there. Sorry if I talk slow, this is my way of talking in a slow way. How I hate this fucking of hairs from the jeans, they stick to the needle. I see something there, some traces in the second layer. I hope I did not cut them. Or I am fucked with this logic board. I hope this is good. G and G need this capacitor I have damaged. Hope it's not short. I will replace the solder. Because that from factory melt harder. Okay, I think I see something. I have scratched in the second layer a trace, but it does not look damaged. You can't see good, I think, in the camera. This what happens. I did not fucking think it will go on the second layer with that needle. Most of times I use the split tweezers to lift some ink, or the chinese too. For some reason I decided to not use them. So first I will clean the old soldier fucking language. No, it's not the language, it's the way I speak. Okay, let me clean this shit. Let me clean this shit and see what is there. Between I replaced my backlight. I mean the microscope light. It was white, but now it's warm white. Can't see that. What I want to tell is that what I see in the microscope, you don't see in the camera, because the camera is not alive. It's not in the same focus. What I see is better than in the camera. It looks better than what I see in the camera. Okay. People. I was scared, but there is nothing damaged. No cut trace. I only have scratched until the second layer. So I was lucky. I was fucking lucky. Okay, that capacitor is damaged, but I think I will not replace it, because this logic bar for solution. I will test if there is some short, and I will see if the short have gone on VDD main. I put on ground one. Okay, as you can see, no, wait, this cap is not short, so I will leave it. I think this was the VDD main. And there is no more short. If I remember proper, I can't open the sheet of schematic now. Let's test if here was some VDD main. I will try remember where is VDD main. I know it goes to the boostic. Where the fuck is that? The shit is cup. If is gliding the multimeter probably. This is ground or something else? Yes, this is ground. And there is a trace, but I did not cut it. I only have scratched. Okay, I will clean the glue that there was a short, but there is no more short. After I remove it, the PMU. This GUI is cleaned easy when the ink is not in place with 200 of temp. You can see that it's cleaned easy. I think this is because there is no PMU. Because when it's in place, it's very hard to clean this shit. I hope you see. Wait, I got 220. Fucking shit. I have burned my fingers with this heat gun. Fuck. The capacitor have lifted. I see the solder melts on the edge. I'm thinking, what the fuck, the solder is so weak to melt or what? I decided to replace the PMU because when I was taking readings on connectors, they were wrong. And I think the short on VDD main was counting that Okay, I think this is not needed to be cleaned between capacitors. Most importantly is that the glue will not be interfering between the IC and components. I will solder these capacitors from the inside because the solder has weakened and I like to do this most of times because you will then have unwanted surprises. There are people that solder NAND but don't clean and then to resolder the components around that were covered by the glue. Then they wonder why the fuck this I have replaced NAND or have rebolted but now the device door is not put. Because you fucking did not clean it, the glue around. And some component may have cold solder around the NAND and you are playing or wondering why the fuck is not working. We can see the trace. It's not damaged. If you don't want to clean, I will fucking help you to clean. No, the trace is not broken, only scratched on the surface. And I think there will not be no problem if I solder the PMU back. I mean the new PMU. So I will put in again because there is some glue. Some particular glue. the method with soldering iron on top, but you must be careful to not run in such heat like I did with this with that needle when I lifted the PMU from the corner. Nothing wrong on the other side. Aluminium plate add on CPU some thermal plate to prevent it to overheat. And stick the logic board to the aluminium plate. Now I will add flux and prepare the place. To solder the PMU. I mean the new PM sheet U. Okay, it looks good. Be careful not to force anything or it will break. A lightning the PMU It looks good. I will give him a chance. To work. I hope I will be fine. I will try with 280 full airflow to solder the new PMU. I think it's not soldered yet. Let me add some flux. And lift to 290. Maybe fucking soldered, but I'm playing here. No, it did not solder. As you can see in the corner of the PMU, maybe because of the paste. So I will give him 300 of temp. It must move when it's soldered. And when it melts out the bolts, the flux that is under the PMU must exit with in the sides, which is a sign that he have soldered. Okay, I think that's done. I have seen the aluminium plate is hot. I don't see bolts, solder bolts on the other side, which is a good sign. I see that PMU have soldered. You can see the bolts are melted, and I can see them all melted fine. Not sure if you can see in the video, but I see in the microscope because I have a clear image. So what can I say? I first will clean the paste that I have added. Then I will test again that capacitor On iPhone 6, I have soldered PMU with 260 of temp. Can you imagine how low temp? Without any metallic plates or paste. But there was a reboarded poo CPU, I mean. And I was not afraid of any bad situations. With thinner, the paste is cleaned very well. As you can see. Also, when I make video, I work slowly. Sorry. So let me test that sheet of cup and see if the PMU is fucking good. Okay, I don't see any short. I see high readings, which means that there is no short. Here is a close up, so you see the bolt. Of melted. Okay, guys, that's it. The PMU is in its place. I hope you liked the method. With more practice, nothing may go wrong. Sorry for my slow talk and slow video recording. I don't like to rush. I hope now my brother will not complain that the readings that he is making are wrong. Honestly, I would test this logic board, but I don't have the needed parts. So that's it, guys. Thanks for watching. Don't forget to visit our Torsion page on Facebook and like it. Share and give credit no matter what. Have a good life. Bye.